What is misappropriation? The Uniform Trade Secrets Act enforcement provisions allow companies and individuals to protect information that qualifies as a trade secret from actual or threatened misappropriation. Misappropriation is 1. Disclosure or use of a trade secret without consent. 2. Acquisition of a trade secret through improper means or acquisition of a trade secret by another, by a person who knows or has reason to know the trade secret was acquired by improper means. Improper means includes theft, bribery, misrepresentation, breach of a duty to maintain secrecy, or espionage through electronic or other means. When would a party allege actual misappropriation? In cases of actual misappropriation, the wrong has already occurred, and the trade secret owner may seek judicial intervention concerning any legal rights that were violated. This is true regardless of whether the misappropriator obtained the secret without the owner's consent or originally with consent but later used the secret for the misappropriator's own gain. The burden of proof in an actual, as opposed to a threatened, misappropriation case falls on the trade secret owner alleging misappropriation. This burden of proof requires the trade secret owner to demonstrate that he or she was in possession of knowledge or information that was not generally known and was valuable because it was not generally known, and that the knowledge or information was subject to reasonable efforts to maintain its secrecy. Proving the elements necessary to make out a trade secret case can be challenging. The best way to establish a foundation for successful prosecution of trade secret misappropriation is to follow a written trade secret protection plan. When would a party allege threatened misappropriation? In cases of alleged threatened misappropriation, the trade secret owner does not contend that their trade secrets have already been misappropriated, but rather that unless some action is taken, their trade secrets will be misappropriated in the future. Threatened misappropriation cases often arise when a highly skilled or trained employee who has been exposed to a company's trade secrets leaves the company and goes to work for a competitor. On the one hand, the former employer may have legitimate concerns about possible disclosure of its trade secrets to a competitor. On the other hand, the employee has a right to work for the employer of his choice. Courts are required to balance these competing interests. When faced with a situation where an employee who has been exposed to trade secrets leaves to work for a new employer, courts typically consider three factors. 1. Whether the former employer and the new employer are competitors. 2. Whether the employee's new position is comparable to his or her former position. And 3. The efficacy of steps taken by the new employer to prevent the misappropriation of trade secrets. Courts will not prohibit the wrongful use or disclosure of trade secrets based upon the mere suspicions of the trade secret owner that some misappropriation may occur. Rather, the trade secret owner is required to demonstrate that the concerns of misappropriation are legitimate and that misappropriation is likely to occur. What types of evidence can be used to support an allegation of threatened misappropriation? A trade secret owner may present direct or circumstantial evidence to demonstrate that there is an imminent threatened misappropriation of trade secrets. Direct evidence exists when the trade secret owner can demonstrate that action has already been taken or words have already been spoken that indicate a misappropriation of trade secrets is going to occur. Common examples of such direct evidence are statements made by the former employee or the new employer. Similarly, the new employer might make statements about the purpose of hiring the new employee, why other potential employees were rejected, or the nature of the duties the new employee will be required to perform. Based on evidence of such actions or statements, a court is likely to protect trade secrets by enjoining prospectively their wrongful use or disclosure. However, in most situations, direct evidence concerning the likelihood of misappropriation does not exist. In such cases, a trade secret owner can present circumstantial evidence to demonstrate that the unauthorized use or disclosure of trade secrets is imminently threatened. There are two types of circumstantial evidence. 1. Evidence demonstrating the intent of a party to elicit the wrongful disclosure of the trade secret. And 2. Evidence demonstrating that the wrongful disclosure or use of a trade secret is inevitable regardless of any party's intentions. Although circumstantial evidence is generally not considered as strong as direct evidence, it is clear that courts will issue injunctions prohibiting the misappropriation of trade secrets based solely on circumstantial evidence that indicates such activity is eminently likely to occur. For example, in PepsiCo Inc. versus Redmond, the defendant moved from a senior position at PepsiCo to a position at rival Quaker Oats Company, then owner of the Gatorade brand, which is now owned by Pepsi. The court held that it was proper for the district court to conclude that based on the defendant's access to Pepsi's trade secrets, it was inevitable as part of the defendant's new employment that the trade secrets would be relied on. The district court concluded that unless the defendant possessed an uncanny ability to compartmentalize information, he would necessarily make decisions for the new employer by relying on the trade secrets. This was true even though there was no direct evidence that Redmond disclosed any of Pepsi's trade secrets. A trade secret owner who suspects either actual or threatened misappropriation must act promptly to enforce his or her legal rights. Although the statute of limitations under the UTSA is 3 years, courts have the power to deny the relief requested by trade secret owners even when an action has been initiated within the statute of limitations period, if the action has not been initiated promptly. The UTSA assumes that a trade secret owner who suspects misappropriation will move with reasonable alacrity to protect his or her intellectual property, and recognizes that if such action is not taken, then third parties may materially change their positions in a good faith belief that no trade secret rights have been violated.